Many of you have been inquiring about my health and the status of the cancer. The last time I spoke with you regarding any details that I had cancer was in a video called Revelation Through Pain, which I advise many of you to watch. If you haven't seen it, I'll put that right up there for you. It's a very, very, very good video. In fact, I believe I know exactly why I'm going through what I'm going through. It's because I'm writing a book called Daniel. Daniel Truly Unsealed. Profound revelations inside that book. And the greater the revelations, the greater the pain. You should watch the video because it's scriptural. In fact, all I give is scriptures. People don't want to believe revelation comes via pain, and yet that's unscriptural, folks. It's unscriptural. In any case, the last time that I dove into kind of what I was about to do was at the very ending of that video, when I said I was going to get admitted and they were going to cut out the cancer, basically, which meant cutting out a good portion of my tongue. They would have took out about almost half of it, all the way to the front of my tongue. That would have been fun and exciting. Let me give you the story and how that went and why that happened and what has transpired. Those of you who don't want to hear about this, you just want to hear about what's going on. I'll probably mention a little bit about Israel towards the very end of the video. Jump to the end of the video. I'm going to give you some storytelling, though, in this part. And what I've been through and the miracles that I've seen. Back to that last video, what had been happening the previous days, my tongue was in extreme pain. I had not been officially diagnosed that I'd had cancer yet, but I knew it was. And days and days before, my tongue was swelling, it was in pain, and it was inflamed. And I gave up. I just said I quit. And the day you saw that, the day I did that video, that evening, my tongue had shrunk probably by half. I was scheduled to go in the next day anyway, which I talked about in the video. I was going to go in. I was going to tell everybody, you admit me. You cut out this thing, get it out of my life, get it out of my tongue. I knew I was going to do that. But that evening, my tongue was getting better. And the next day was like a different tongue completely. I was taking it as if God was healing me. In fact, that's what I believed. So when I went down there, saw the surgeon, the doctor, he didn't care what it was. In fact, I was kind of saying, I don't care what it is. It's got to come out. It doesn't matter what it is. It's coming out. And I'm like, I've flipped. I did a whole 180 in a matter of 24-hour period. I said, I don't think so at the moment. He says, well, then let me do a biopsy. And that was really exciting. I told Elizabeth, my wife, I said, I'm not going to let them. They can say anything they want to say, except I don't want them cutting out pieces of my tongue. And yet my wife wanted the biopsy. Happy wife, happy life. So they proceed to give me shots, and I'm pulling my tongue back. I'm having to hold my tongue so he can shoot into my tongue, I guess, numbing agents. He did that a couple times and sprayed me, and that was fun. I like hairspray on my tongue. And then he takes this little cylinder thing, and it's about this long. There's a cylinder at the end. And he starts going like this, moving it back and forth, going into my tongue. As I'm holding my tongue, he's going in, and it's digging a hole in my tongue. He takes that out, gets some tweezers, pulls it out, and snips off the piece of my tongue. While, of course, some blood's squirting in the doctor's eye, and that's going everywhere. And I'm kidding. The whole blood was coming out. He decides he's going to cauterize the wound. He burns my tongue, so to stop the bleeding. That was the whole. It was a great experience. I everybody should try it. And I knew it was going to come back. He's rescheduled. You know, we were going to come back, and it was cancer. We went back and it was cancer. And he says, okay, now what are you going to do about it? And I still, now was kind of, I didn't really know what was going on. They'll come back to this. It all makes sense in a little bit. But anyway, I said, okay, I'll do whatever you want. I'll take it up to the point, which is what I told Elizabeth. I'll take everything up to the point to where all of a sudden they're chopping up my tongue. Because I believed inwardly I could beat this thing. I've seen God beat this. He can do anything. And my faith is there for anything. I did a video to where my mother-in-law, my wife's mom, had went through cancer. And I'll put that video up there. A lot of miracles in that video too, including her healing. Powerful video. So my faith, I know some of you, some of you are telling me to pray, Steve, and fast and anoint yourself with oil and all these different things. My faith is already there, folks. I grew up that way, knowing God can do anything. But sometimes, through pain, trials, and tribulations, which we are expected to go through, we sometimes have to walk through them. So you have to be led. You have to be guided. You have to ask God, how do you want me to proceed? Where's the path? Show me the way. And you know in the end, he's going to show you the way, and he's going to show you that you're going to make through. And we have to go through at times. We're not always bypassing the trial in any case. So I said, okay, fine, I'll do whatever up to the point. And so that meant scheduling the surgeon. See the surgeon. He gave me three choices. Tell him to take a flying leap. I've considered it. Cut out the piece, which became way more than just the piece. And maybe radiation. Or I could choose chemo and radiation. I said, okay, I'll do chemo and radiation. See, folks, I believed and have believed that my call is distinct. It requires my tongue. And in fact, I did a video, prophecy with Tracy Cook prophesying over us just the month before, prophesying how God had called me. He said twice through Tracy Cook.
Even as I prophesied before the next 9 months, from today in 9 months, God said, hear my spirit, son. I've called thee, saith the Lord, to be a voice, to be a preacher.
I've called you to be a voice. Well, if I lose my tongue, I don't know what kind of voice I'm going to have. Maybe God changed his mind. I was really, but anyway, I kept my faith. So we schedule the chemo guy, and we go see the chemo guy, who's basically telling me, he's not giving me any hope, no hope whatsoever. In fact, he tells me the radiation guy, which we're supposed to see the very next day, radiation is like taking a blowtorch to your tongue. Wow, that's exciting. This gave me the blowtorch now. I mean, I really don't want to go through this over and radiation lasts 6 weeks. So I was out of it, folks. And we go out to eat. Because we're in the Springs, which is 2 hours away from where we live. In fact, thanks to the Raven, I have a big Raven. It's God, but I have a big, sorry. I should cut it out. A Raven who makes things happen on this channel. And right now I'm going through a lot already, folks. I'm sorry. Cancer's a big deal. You can keep the faith and you can have the joy, but your emotions peak out when you're sick also. Now, and I'm not saying that. I mean, I probably feel the exact same way because I have my appreciation for the people who have blessed this channel. And it came down to going back and forth, or just can we just pay a little extra, spend the night at a hotel, because we were just this doctor thing. And he made that happen to where we were down there. Anyway, so we go out to eat, having just had the great news from the chemo guy. And I'm in the restaurant. we're sitting down, and the food has come, and I try not to get emotional. I mean, I don't mind here because I know there's mostly Christians, but anybody else who's worldly, they don't understand you be having a big heart. They expect you to be hard and you don't cry about a whole lot of anything. And I know how to be that way too. And I like being that way. In fact, just pushing off God, and it makes you a hardened heart. And God wants you to give you a heart not of stone, but of flesh. That aside, I'm praying to God. And I'm telling God, you know what? I'm pushing aside the Tracy Cook we just had, prophecy just had a month before, pushing aside all the things that I've had from my youth that I've never even got to talk about, that I know, that I've yet to see. And I told God, I mean, man, what do I know? Maybe he's changed his mind as far as I know, even though the gifts and calling are without repentance. I'm telling God, you know what? You didn't have to allow this. You didn't have to put cancer on me. You want me to stop talking? Just ask. Because folks, I've got to tell you, I didn't call myself. I've said this a million times. God called me. I didn't call me. I know there's plenty of people that call themselves, but that ain't the way it's been with my life. I've known from my youth. I gave you a prophecy from John Paul Jackson who prophesied something along the lines of,
you had a call of God when you were in your early teen years, and you knew God had called you into the ministry.
There are things that happened to me that I've never talked about. Yes, in my early teen years, I knew God had called me into the ministry. But what happened? You can't ignore what you're looking at, right? On the one hand, you hear God called you, and on the other hand, you're dealing with cancer that may cut out your tongue. That's the reality, folks. So I'm sitting there telling God, you know what? If you wanted me to stop talking, and I'm being serious, I'm not being mean, I don't have animosity at God. I'm not blaming him. I'm telling him, if you wanted me to stop talking, you didn't have to do this. All you had to do was just ask. I'd quit. It's not like I have a chip on my shoulder and I have to talk. You want me to stop? I'll talk. Now I'll quit and I'll take away the cancer. Please. So I'm telling God, I'm done. That was it. I've hit a couple points in this time of my life. This is another one of those times to where I said, I'm done. I told him it's over. And as I told God, as I said, I'm done, it's over. On the radio, I don't listen to the radio. If I'm in the car, I'm listening to news. If I'm in my house, I'm listening on the television, I'm listening to news. I don't listen to the music. However, on the radio, as I said, it's over, comes the words,
hey now, hey now, don't dream it's over. Hey now, hey now.
And I start to lose it. I had just said, I just told God, it's over. Just ask, I'll quit. I don't need it. You know, I'm here only because you told me to be. And I'm losing it. And Elizabeth, my wife, is looking at me, lose it, in a restaurant. And I'm holding it back. I'm doing my best to hold it back, and I'm just like this. And she goes, what's wrong? I said, the song. And I'm sure she thought, you know, what are you, reminiscent about some young, you know, pre-teen, or whatever, I don't know what the song, I guess I'd be about 30. Yes, I'm reminiscing about some old relationship I had. I'm sure that's kind of what she thought. But I can't explain it because I'm holding it back. I'm holding back my tears. Finally, when I was able to get a grip, I said the song, I was just telling, she didn't know I was praying. I said the song just answered my prayer. And she's kind of looking at me, not knowing what to think. And I'm sure some of you are thinking the same thing. You don't really know what to think. Steve, God's talking through a song. Listen to me, folks. God ministers through songs a lot. I don't listen to them, but I know he ministers to them because I've seen it happen. In this particular case, Some of you think, well, this is a secular. Folks, listen, God could talk through anything. He could talk through a billboard. He can talk through a rock. He can talk through a donkey. One time I was telling somebody, I was telling the Raven. I believe it was the Raven here recently. What had happened? Danny Davis, my former pastor, and I were out driving. I was in a car to where the belt kept breaking. It had been a two-year problem. Belt kept breaking. The alternator belt kept breaking. I took it to three different places to try to get the thing fixed. Kept breaking. I was so fed up with the thing. So it broke again, and we had to pull over side of the road. This drunk, I'm sorry, the man was drunk. He was homeless. You could tell he was homeless. Didn't take a rocket scientist. And the guy walks up, says, we got the hoods up at the car. Danny and I are looking at the engine. Guy walks up, says, what's wrong? I said, belt broke. And he goes in a drunken voice, said, well, this, that. You take care of that, it's fixed. Danny looked at me and said, I think God just spoke to that man. I looked at Danny and I said, I think so too. I take it down to a different station. Can you do this, that? And when we got the car back, the problem was fixed. Three different stations prior could not fix the problem, even if they thought they were experts and thought they knew how, and I'll just be more, it was a Corvette, it was a beautiful Corvette, modified, and everybody thought they knew what they were doing, except God knew what he was doing, and he used a homeless drunk. So some of you think God can't speak through anything, he can use anything, even a secular song. However, me and my skeptical guy that I am, I told the wife, I said, you know what? I give that about a 50-50 chance that was God. I'm a very skeptical man. I never had God speak through a song, a secular song, immediately, quite like that. In fact, I never had anything like that. So I left it at that, and I went, because it affected me. It affected me so much, we went back to the hotel. We were in a hotel that night, thanks to the Raven. And I'm listening to the song, and I'm like, okay, the only thing that ministers to me at all. The song goes something like there's freedom within, freedom being, I took that as liberty. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. So there's liberty within, there's liberty without. He's saying freedom. Goes on, he says, in the beginning of the song, there's a battle ahead, many battles are lost. But you never see the end of the road when you're traveling with me. Now, if that is a minute, but the rest of the song didn't minister to me at all. And I told Elizabeth, I said, well, if God was talking, it was only the beginning of the song, and that's really all that ministered to me. So I said, okay, and I was feeling God, and I said, I give this a 75% chance. Next day, we go see the radiation guy, who he excited me a whole lot. He basically said, you know, well, I give this about a 10% chance that this is going to work. He said, however, we can extend it from 6 weeks to 7 weeks. But then, according to the stats, you got about a 25% chance that you're going to have your jaw it's going to have a problem. It's going to have to be operated on because it's going to destroy the bone and all. I'm like, this is great. You know, this is really exciting. So he was less guy to see at that time that we were there. So the wife and I, on the way home, stopped to get something to eat again. Again, thanks to the Raven, who was making all this happen. Anyway. We're in the restaurant. It's time to go. I want to stop, and I need to use the bathroom. Got to do my thing. And as I'm getting ready to leave the bathroom, I had not paid to this is a different restaurant. Different place, different radio station, and on the station comes on Don't Dream It's Over by a different artist even. It was on a completely different type of station. Different artist, different restaurant. So it had just started. I thought, you've got to be kidding me. And I walk out. Elizabeth's there. I said, listen. She goes, hey now. I said, yes, listen to the, I've not been paying attention. I don't pay attention to the radio. Except this jumped out at me. Different artists were singing it differently, but it was, hey now. And she, and listen, and then it had just started. By the time I got it, it's just finishing, getting ready to, it hits the chorus, and it stopped. And then it went to another song. And my eyes got even bigger. I said, do you realize that was just the first portion of the song? Folks, just the night before, I said, if God was talking, the only portion that he ministered to me on was the first portion of the song. So I'm like, the song's on again by a different artist, different place, different station, and all I get is the first portion of the song. And then it changes to another song. I told him, okay, Elizabeth, I said, you know, I give this now about a 98-99% chance God's telling me to stop thinking that way. So I left it at that. Told God, okay, I'm not going to dream it's over. You're not telling me that it's over, because I would have quit. This video wouldn't be happening. Or it'd be a farewell, and I've done one of those before. So we continue on with our search. Okay, we're calling around trying to find various ways, other methods on how to do this other than to cut out my tongue, which destroys my call. There's got to be a way. If God's called you to do something and you're being given an option that says that eliminates what he's called you to do, then I would say don't do that. Anything but that. So we're calling different clinics. Come across one person as I'm getting ready to dismiss him. And I did dismiss him, but, or the clinic, I should say, cancer clinic. I said, I may want to run at the end. I may not even like what you guys are doing. And I explained to him, I said, I've been that way before, Drew. I just quit. I was ready to go into the hospital and they were going to operate on me because my tongue was swelling. And he says, you know, when the tumor cell dies, it's going to swell as it's dying. And I'm like, a whole light bulb went off in my head. What had happened, folks? I had been fasting on that video. Before I did that video that night, I was fasting and I was eating a certain way and I was taking a certain stuff. In any case, the day I did that video, Pain Through Revelation, I quit. I told you I'd quit. I had pizza and everything else that was about as junky as you could eat, but oh, I loved it. I loved it. And that evening, my tongue was shrinking. By the next day, when I saw the surgeon, which I thought a miracle was happening, my tongue was practically back to, I mean, it was the tumor was so small. No more swelling, no more inflammation, no more pain. It was so perfect that I was ready to tell everybody to go take a flying leap. But what was happening was that I was in the process of killing the tumor. That is why it was swelling. That is why it was painful. That is why the day I ate every piece of junk food I could get my hands on, that by the evening, that thing was all coming down because the tumor was all happy. It was being fed what it wanted to be fed. And within 24 hours, it was like shrunk to half. I was killing it. That was a process to figure out. And when that guy told me that, that's what happens in the process of a tumor dying. Expect it to swell. I knew I had the ability to, I don't know how long it would take, but I know I was in the process of killing the thing. We kept calling around. So anyway, that was a light bulb. Called around and wound up with a place in Mexico that I did go to. I've been back since the 4th. We've been out of the country. They had things that they were able to do there that is not allowed in the United States. Large doses of B17 being one of them, you could be restricted with B17. In fact, I even think it's illegal. But anyway, if you were to use it, it's such a small dose. they did all the common things like vitamin C and lots of other stuff, but they were also, they also got into immunotherapy. I'm not going to teach on immunotherapy, but basically what it is, they take your own blood out, they reprogram it to recognize the cancer, and then they put it back into you. It takes a period of about 6 months, about 6 weeks to incubate the and get the blood ready and that kind of thing. They were doing that, and I wanted that because the success rate on that is pretty astronomical. So I had to go to Mexico to get that done. My immunotherapy vials are due to me probably within the next 2 weeks. There's other things that are still happening with me that I keep implementing that have come from them and that are being given to me that are part of the therapy. So it's been a road, it's been a process. However, in the process of the expenditures that have, thanks to you folks, I'll say it one time again, folks, thank you for those who give. Thank you for your prayers. I am in need still of your prayers. Where I'm about to go right now, what's going to be a 4-month process of this immunotherapy, among the other things that are the vitamin C's and the B17s and baking soda and lots of different stuff that I don't want to get into that are part of my therapies. In fact, I might give you a picture of my counter of all the different things I have to go through every single day. And I have the ability. This has the ability. Our prayers are greater. God is greater than this. I'm not to quit. It's not over. And I've seen a lot of things that make me happy. However, I want to thank everybody that's given, because you helped in that process of me getting there. And so as Raven and so as other people that have helped you folks, I wouldn't be able to have done this, but I'm going to say this. I racked up a $20,000 bill that's left for me to pay. Thankfully, they did it over the course of a year. It's $1,500 extra a month, which takes me from a normal of $2,500 a month to now $4,000 a month. If any of you feel led to give whatever monies, in fact, I had one person write on the check, said cancer. You can put, if you want to call up and give, if you want, I'll put the information down below. You want to mail in, you want to pay via PayPal. Put if you want to give strictly to the cancer. I know some of you have hearts just to give towards people that are sick. I know some of you are like that. And you know what? Jesus' heart was towards the sick and the poor. I think right now I'm a little bit of both of that. If you feel led, we will apply. If you say cancer, it'll go right to that. If not, it'll go to other expenditures of, right, as we still have monthly bills. And I'm going to tell you something, folks, which I'm going to kind of get off now of the cancer part.
Who's Elizabeth? You know anybody? Your name is Elizabeth? God said, lay hands on Elizabeth, because I'm going to cause her to be pregnant with the greatest miracle she's ever seen. And the Lord said, watch me from this now in the next month, 9 months, I'm going to do a miracle. And God said, to tell you the best. Even as I prophesied before the next 9 months, from today in 9 months, God said, hear my spirit, son. And God's going to cause you, even the next 9 months, to birth something you have never birthed before, even the last 4 years that have been testing years. But now your harvest season is just beginning right around the corner.
This year, before November 20th, he didn't say 8 months, he said 9 months. So that means after October 20th, before November 20th, we're going to start birthing something that was greater and had never been birthed before. I think I know what it is, and I think it's because things are going to start happening. Some of you need to get ready. If this is where we are, you're not ready in the slightest. There's one other thing I told people where to go and what to do. There's a video. I'll put one more video up for you to watch. If you don't know where to go and what to do, when you see these things start happening, folks, you better get ready. You better get your house in order, and you better know where to go and what to do. It's not going to be to hang around Babylon, because this place is going to go bye-bye. I need your prayers. Please, I covet your prayers. If you feel like helping us, whatever you give will go towards future months. I don't know that anybody has $20,000, but the Raven does, but he's not, I'm not talking to the Raven. You hear me, Raven? I'm not talking to you. Other people can help. Last thing, finally, I'm going to finish writing Daniel. I need the next month or 2 months to finish Daniel. I don't want to be thinking about the news or responding in emails or the next video. Unless God forces me back with a video, I'm going to be writing Daniel, and I want to be out of commission, solely in prayer and focused on writing Daniel. Okay? That's what I want to do. So unless I'm forced back, give me about a month or two to finish Daniel, and hopefully I can come back to you with a book, Daniel Truly Unsealed. Look for more to come. Keep your eyes open, folks. Things are happening fast. Till then, take care and God bless.